on October 24th, 2023, the alert level was raised at a volcano in Alaska which often hosts puffin colonies. This change occurred at 2:55 p.m. local time, where the Bogoslof volcano was raised from an alert level of white to an alert level of yellow. As, since October 22nd, an unusually intense earthquake storm has been occurring in close proximity to Bogoslof Island, specifically along a line of activity. This line could be inferred as a possible dike intrusion of magma which, if the earthquakes were occurring right above the hypothetical magma, would indicate molten rock at a depth of approximately 4 to 4.5 miles. This has involved more than 100 earthquakes so far, representing such a high rate that I would not be all that surprised if a volcanic eruption followed. As Bogoslof is not really known to produce similarly sized earthquake storms without magma being involved. As a result of all of this unrest, I would place Bogoslof on my 0 to 10 opinion-based volcanic unrest scale as a 6, meaning I think its current unrest is more intense than currently being witnessed at two other United States volcanoes also at a raised alert level, Kilauea in Hawaii and Trident in Alaska. While seismic activity has seemingly decreased during the last 12 hours, the overall nature of this seismicity implies a magmatic origin in my opinion, even though statistically most magmatic intrusions at volcanoes never reach the surface. So, exactly where is this volcano which few have ever heard of? The Bogoslof volcano is located within the Aleutian Island chain, where it is 841 miles west-southwest of the city of Anchorage. While no people live on this small, only 320-acre island, the island is often populated by numerous fur seals and even cute puffins. Before its last eruption began in 2016, this island was even covered with some grasses and green vegetation, but this plant life was subsequently incinerated by pyroclastic flows. However, the other islands in fairly close proximity to this small and ashy island are not completely unpopulated, which is why this volcano can pose a potential hazard. The closest settlement has a population of 4,000, aka the town of Unalaska, and since this region of the Aleutians is frequently used as a commercial airline route to fly over, any eruption could not only cause minor amounts of ash to fall on one or more of the several nearby towns, but also disrupt air traffic. This is what, for example, occurred on May 16, 2017 when a trace amount of ash fell on the town of Nikolsky, originating due to a 34,000-foot-tall Vulcanian eruption column. While most eruptions of Bogoslof are far smaller, the example I just stated is one reason why it is rated as a moderate threat volcano by the US Geological Survey. From an initial glance, the Bogoslof volcano might only look like a small and highly unstable island which doesn't climb very far from the sea floor. And yet, the half a square mile landmass above the Bering Sea represents less than 1% of this overall volcano, and I do not simply mean the smaller 1883 vent lava dome half a mile to the north-northwest. As the other 99% of this volcano lies underwater, consisting of an 11-mile-wide stratovolcano that towers 6,000 feet from the ocean floor. Back on the surface, Bogoslof's central island could be best described as frequently changing in shape, being composed primarily out of loose unconsolidated ash that clings onto less common but far more solid basaltic lava domes produced during eruptions. For example, in 2009, the 1992 lava dome which formed was completely surrounded by the ocean. Yet, today, it is surrounded by approximately 6 feet thick of ash and is connected to three other lava domes as part of a single landmass. If Bogoslof was to erupt again, it in my opinion would probably erupt in a Sertsayan manner with a white and black eruption plume like shown in this video with a volcanic explosivity index rating of a 2 or a 3. In the next few days to weeks, one of four scenarios could play out, which I have modeled on screen. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.